my side, and let me share the screen. Right, okay. So in case you want to install anything, okay, from where you can install, you can on the server, you can use server manager to install any software. In case you want to install .NET framework or else, don't think like you can install SQL server from server manager. No, Windows server related components like .NET framework and Active Directory domain services, cluster services, Windows related components you can install from the server manager. Okay, now I want to install I want to install the .NET framework, right? So .NET framework we are going to use, okay, .NET framework 3.5 and 4.5. okay, right. One minute, please. Someone pinged me. Please give permissions to record. Okay, let me give you the permissions. Yes, you can record. Okay, right, fine. Right, okay. So now I want to install .NET framework, right? So just log into the server and click on this add roles and features option. Okay, in case you want to install any component, you have to click on the add roles and features option only. This work will be done by the Windows team, guys. We don't install .NET framework. Okay, after Windows server is commissioned, means after Windows server is ready, Windows people are going to install all the required softwares in the Windows machine. Okay, for most of the Microsoft components, .NET framework is important. So once Windows machine is ready, once Windows people install the Windows machine, then they are going to configure, okay, they are going to install .NET framework also immediately. If you don't see .NET framework, then you can let them know so that they are going to install the .NET framework. Okay, right, go to next. Role based, feature based, keep it as it is, don't change. Go to next. Go to next. Okay, go to next. These are the roles. Actually, .NET framework is a feature. You can see the feature in the next screen. Go to next. There you can see features. Under features, you can see .NET framework 3.5 and .NET framework 4.5. Expand this triangle. Select this .NET framework 3.5. Select this HTTP activation, add features, non-HTTP activation, and 4.5 is already selected, right? Go next, next, next. Here you have to select this specify an alternate source path. Click on this. Actually, your software is there in the, yesterday we just set up Windows Server software, right? Windows operating system. Okay, using this server, using this Oracle VirtualBox Manager, yesterday we attached ISO image for Windows Server operating system. Yesterday, if you remember it or not, we have attached. Actually, your .NET framework software is there in the Windows Server operating system only. Okay, so your Windows Server operating system is there in the D drive. Okay, here in the D drive, it was there. Okay, so let me open. There you can see in the sources folder. Okay, the file will be there. So what we have to do, okay, we have to simply copy this path here in the SXX folder. Yes, XS. Okay, if you don't know, no need to remember. Here you can see, right, /sources/SXS, right? In the same way, there is no E drive. Our software is there in the D drive, right? D:// same folder, /sources/X|X||. Okay, the same path like this. Instead of E drive, I just gave D drive. Why? Because my Windows operating system is there in the D drive, right? So that's why I gave D drive here. And you can just click OK. And you can just click install. So that .NET framework will be installed. It will take 2 minutes. It won't take much time.
Shanmugh?
Yes.
Actually, you are connecting.
Sorry, your voice is breaking. Yes. Sharat, I cannot hear you, Sharat. Hello, Sharat. Hello. Sharat, I cannot hear you.